Good evening, and welcome to Tompkins-Cortland Community College. Our ceremony will begin in a few moments. As we convene to celebrate the accomplishments of our students, we request those present to observe the significance of this event by engaging in courtesy and kindness in our actions and words. Please take a moment to observe the emergency exits around you. They're located in the front of the gymnasium to the right, directly to the rear of the gymnasium, and in the rear of the gymnasium to the left. In the unlikely event of an emergency, please proceed in a calm and orderly fashion to the closest emergency exit unless otherwise directed by a member of our campus police department. Thank you. Tonight's commencement will formally begin with the entrance into the gymnasium of Professors Janet Swinich and Christina Stavenhagen Helgren. These longtime faculty members are retiring from the college following a distinguished career. Professor Stavenhagen Helgren after 24 years and Professor Swinich after 41 years. Professor Swinich is carrying the ceremonial mace to signify their shared roles as tonight's Grand Marshals. Following the Grand Marshals will be the college's registrar, Katrina Campbell, leading the class of 2024. Members of the faculty and staff will be next, with the official party and President Amy Kremenek concluding the procession into the gym. Now, for those that are able, we ask that you please rise and remain standing throughout the processional as we begin Tompkins-Cortland Community College's 55th commencement exercises.
Thank you. Good evening. I'm Professor Janet Swinich.
Oh, that's good. Huh? And I'm Professor Christina Stavenhagen-Helgren, and we and we are honored to serve as Grand Marshals for the 2024 Tompkins Cortland Community College Commencement Exercises.
Chairperson Davison, President Kremenek, members of the faculty and staff, honored guests, families, and friends, the candidates for certificates and associate degrees are duly assembled for our annual commencement exercises.
Therefore, as the Grand Marshals of this event, we hereby declare these proceedings open. Please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem.
Seated.
Good evening. I'm Judy Davison, Chair of the College Board of Trustees, which represents the people of Tompkins and Cortland counties. It's my pleasure to be at this very special occasion as we celebrate the 55th graduating class of TC3. To our students, we are extremely proud of each and every one of you. I know I speak for the Board of Trustees when I say you are simply inspiring. This achievement is the culmination of a great deal of hard work, and we're honored to be part of your celebration. Allow me to congratulate you on behalf of the Board of Trustees. We wish you nothing but the best in everything that you do. Allow me to also acknowledge two other important groups of people. We are very fortunate at TC3 to have a very dedicated faculty and staff members who are committed to our students' success, and we thank you. Finally, congratulations to the family and friends of our students. You have supported our graduates on their journey, and you rightfully share in the pride of their accomplishments. Our students have done great things, and your support has played a major role. Thank you all. Again, congratulations to everyone. Please enjoy your evening.
Thank you, Judy, and good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Amy Kremenek, the president of Tompkins Cortland Community College. It is my distinguished privilege to bring greetings to the 499 members of the class of 2024, as well as all of you who have played an important role in the accomplishment that we are celebrating tonight. Let me first take this opportunity to introduce the members of the official party. I'll ask that the members please stand as I call your name and remain standing. I also ask that you please hold your applause until I have named everyone. On the platform representing our faculty are academic community coordinators, instructor Teresa Tambasio from the Communications and Creative Arts community, Professor Danielle Bethany of the Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics community, Professor Patty Tavara of the Health, Human Services, and Recreation community, Assistant Professor Cindy Whitney of the Social Sciences community, and Professor Sue Stafford of the Business and Hospitality community. The college's registrar, Katrina Campbell. Tonight's Grand Marshals, Professor Christina Stavenhagen-Helgren and Professor Janet Swinich. Vice President of Student Affairs, Seth Thompson. Members of the Board of Trustees, Dean Corbin, Lisa Perfetti, Shelley Michelle Nunn, Roxanne Buck, Vice Chair Sue Dale Hall, Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. Paul Reifenheiser, our Student Trustee, Romnia Quinnell, and Board Chair, Judy Davison. Please join me in a round of applause. Thank you. And I am pleased to also welcome the administrators, faculty, and staff of Tompkins-Cortland Community College. We appreciate the presence and support of each of these individuals on this very special evening. Please join me in a round of applause for our faculty, staff, and administrators. I am also very pleased to welcome some very distinguished guests. The Mayor of Dryden, the Honorable Mike Murphy, our Foundation Board Chair, Regina Grantham, fellow board members, Doug Bentley, Greg Richards, and Mary Stowe. It is our honor to have you here with us tonight. So please join me in a round of applause. And we are here tonight to recognize the class of 2024. Let me tell you a little bit about this class. 227 of our graduates, or about 55%, reside in Tompkins or Cortland County. New York State residents account for nearly 95% of our class, and we do have some graduates from other states, such as Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Massachusetts, Kentucky, Florida, and Texas. We also have 21 students who came from even farther away, other countries including the Dominican Republic, Honduras, Haiti, Belgium, Cameroon, Gabon, Ghana, Kenya, Morocco, Netherlands, and the Ukraine. Please join me in a round of applause for this group. Not only do our graduates come from a wide range of hometowns, and they also have a wide range of ages. Our youngest graduate tonight is 17, and our oldest is 64 years old. In fact, there are four graduates over 60 years young. They are truly lifelong learners. On the younger end, 96 of our graduates tonight are completing a very impressive feat. They are graduating from TC3 with an associate's degree at the same time they are graduating from their respective high schools, 15 different schools, in fact. That means they've not only kept up with their typical workload of a high school student and all of the social and extracurricular demands of graduating high school seniors, but they've also completed all of the requirements for a two-year college degree at the same time through TC3's College Now program. It is truly an impressive accomplishment. Applause. 35 of our graduates represented the college on the fields of athletic competition. We were very proud to have them wear our Panthers uniform. So yes, let's give them an applause too. We also have with us tonight one of our graduates who is a veteran of the United States military, wearing a different uniform. Yes, of course. Wearing a uniform as a member of the United States Armed Forces, we honor you and thank you for your service. A remarkable number of our graduates, 45, are members of the Phi Theta Kappa National Honor Society for two-year colleges. These students have maintained a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.5. Another impressive number, 88 of you received the President's Citation, so I got to sign your letters, during your time here. That goes to a student who has completed at least 30 credits with an overall GPA of 3.8 or better. To all of you, on behalf of our proud faculty and staff, congratulations. Today's celebration is not limited to our graduates. Partners, spouses, parents, children, and special friends of candidates, you are here because you are an important person to one of our graduates. It is a tradition that goes back to the first graduation ceremony here at TC3 to give a title to those of you who have supported our graduates throughout their studies. We call you sponsors. You were there when the candidates needed comfort. You gave them a pep talk when things didn't go the way they wanted. You supported them when they were stressed. This is your day as well as theirs, and this celebration would not be complete without recognizing you. So let's all recognize the parents, grandparents, relatives, partners, spouses, children, and friends of the candidates for their graduation with a round of applause. Thank you for the vital role that you have played. We all have reason to celebrate, but tonight really is about our students. That's why I'm so looking forward to hearing some thoughts from one of our own students. As is tradition at TC3, the student greetings will be delivered by the student body's elected representative to the college's Board of Trustees. Romnia Quinnell was elected to that role for the 23-24 academic year and has served admirably as the voice of the students on the college's governing board. Among other things, she has been an RA in our residence halls, a member of Phi Theta Kappa, a peer mentor, and a student conduct board member. She has displayed a commitment to this college community and an eagerness to get help for her fellow students whenever she can. She is graduating tonight and heading off to get her bachelor's degree in biology. And we're all sure that Romnia is going on to do great things. So please join me in a warm welcome for tonight's student speaker, Romnia Quinnell.
Thank you, Amy. I wrote a whole speech for you all, and I still don't really know how to find the right words to speak to you all tonight. Because tonight marks a turning point for all of us. We are standing at this threshold between our past and our future that we yet do not know. And a quote from Marie Curie comes to mind. She says, "Nothing in life is to be feared. It is only to be understood. Now is the time to understand more so that we may fear less." Her words to me sum up the essence of our journey here at TC3. Because all of us have faced challenges and uncertainties, but we've used that fear as a springboard to enter understanding and use it as a basis for knowledge and for growth. Some of us here tonight are viewing TC3 as the last stop in their academic journeys before heading into the workforce, while others are choosing to see it as a springboard for further education. But all of us have been privileged to have people around us, with us, to support us and cheer us on even when we doubted ourselves. We've learned invaluable lessons from our professors, but we have not learned only through this academic setting that college has given us. We've learned from our peers, our friends, and from ourselves. We have all embraced this daunting task of learning that was set forth to us, and now the responsibility falls to us to ensure that our time here was fruitful and not waste, to ensure that we reap the benefits of what we have sown here. We have begun to embark upon a mad and wonderful journey that is the continuation of the journey we started 2 years ago or more. It has been incredible and crazy, and I'm sure I could go on for hours about all of the memories I have made here, good and bad. I'm sure we can all remember those times when we've rolled out of bed in the mornings to barely make it to class or just not gone at all. We've all cursed out our past selves, I imagine, for choosing to put us through the seemingly never-ending cycle of quizzes and assignments, wondering when it would ever end. But too, we have had made countless memories here. We've made new friends, we've bonded with our roommates, we've joked and laughed and learned more about ourselves and each other. We remember the bonfires at the beginning of each fall semester. We remember the semi-formals, the career fairs, these activities and events that have brought us all together to laugh and learn and to live. All of us are standing here today because we have persevered throughout the highs and the lows. We made it through the other side, guys. We did it. And despite how it might have felt at times, the sky did not fall. The world did not end. We survived. We succeeded. And all of us should be so proud of that fact, not only for graduating, but for all of the accomplishments that we have done here, large and small, for sticking to our goals and achieving them, and for not giving up on them or on ourselves. Not all of us here may have been close, and some of us may have grown apart, and some may not have known each other at all. But we have all created a community here that is forever bonded by these shared experiences and memories. Each of us has something to contribute to the world, a unique gift that everyone desperately needs. We have talents to share, perspectives to share. We have knowledge to learn and to impart. And we have lives to touch and to change for the better, both our own and the lives of strangers. Outside these walls lie our futures. The obstacles we have all encountered and conquered in order to stand where we are today, they have shaped us for the better. And our ability to light up the darkness around us hinges only on our ability and willingness to strike that spark. I hope that we all will seize the opportunities we make through our lives and live free of regrets, that we will face any challenges head on with resilience and strength. And throughout our lives, may we all strive to have more strangers that become friends than friends that become strangers. Congratulations, every one of you.
Thank you, Ramnia, for your remarks and for your service as a member of the Board of Trustees and the student body. Now we would like to honor some of our highest achievers, students who have been given awards for excellence in the classroom and beyond. For that recognition, I invite Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. Paul Reifenheiser, to the podium.
Hello and good evening. These students have already been presented their awards earlier this year, but we'd like to recognize them tonight. I ask that our students, if I say your name, would you please stand in your seat? And I ask for everyone to please hold their applause until the end. And if you're curious, a description for each of the awards can be found in your program. The 2024 Alumni Association Award winner is Christina Vigliotti Martinez. Okay. No one ever follows that when you say hold until the end. It's just not a thing. Okay. The Glennis Cordero Graphic Design Award recipient is John Micah. The Hushang Bahar Memorial Award, named after the college's first president, was given to Crystal Van Petten. The Theodore J. Szymanski Award was given to Emily Wendella and Candon Westervelt. Congratulations to these students. You can be seated. Thank you. A number of awards were presented at our nursing recognition ceremony earlier today, and we'd like to recognize them as well. The Twin Tiers County Award went to Erica Molnar, and if you would please rise in your seat as well. The Florence Nightingale Award was presented to Kylie Fish and Shannon Ostrander. The Spirit of Nursing and Linda Reynolds Memorial Award went to Crystal Van Petten. The TC3 Nursing Faculty Award was given to Caitlin Simmons and Gracie White. And the Catherine A. Dunham RN Memorial Award was given to Brittany Halleck and Kimberly McNally. Not here, but congratulations to all of those recipients as well.
Thank you, Dr. Reifenheiser. We did have earlier today a pinning ceremony for our nursing students who were here today to receive their awards and accolades, so we congratulate them as well. Tompkins-Cortland Community College is part of the State University of New York. Each year, all 64 of this, the largest state university system in the country, nominate their best to compete for the prestigious Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence. We are proud that this year two of our own were selected. Mary Beth Ortlieb and Louis Scholl, would you please stand? Thank you. Thank you. And I need to add that Louis served as a student trustee on the college's Board of Trustees last year, so it's good to see you. Student Chancellor's Awards are recognized by the Chancellor for their exceptional commitment to academic success and to enriching not only themselves, but also the campus community. These awards were presented by SUNY Chancellor John King at a ceremony in April, and I was honored to be there to recognize these outstanding students, and I'm so pleased to do so again this evening. Mary Beth and Louis, congratulations. In addition to these awards for academic excellence and service to the college community, we also honor TC3 alumni each year. The Distinguished Alumni Award is awarded to an alumnus of the college who has excelled in his or her professional life and in service to the campus community. This award is an effort of the TC3 Foundation, and in particular, its alumni committee. This year, we have two distinguished alumni recipients, Tom Pinnell and Andrew Pierce. Will you please join me on stage? So we will start with Thomas J. Pinnell, a 2002 graduate with a degree in engineering science. He continued on for his bachelor's degree and his master's degree at the University of Buffalo. As a grad student, he had the opportunity to do his research at Cornell University's nanoscale facility, a world-class facility for micro and nano fabrication. His time there made quite the impression and quite the impact on him. Fast forward through about a decade of working in the industry, and Tom finds himself back at the Cornell nanoscale facility, this time working as a professional in one of the top facilities of its kind in the country. He has been there since 2015, supporting the research of hundreds of Cornell graduate students. In 2019, he added the responsibilities of educational outreach coordinator, and in that role is helping to shape the next generation of technicians, engineers, and scientists. And in a life comes full circle moment, he is now working with TC3 on training students in the field of semiconductors. He is using what he has learned through the years, starting here at TC3, to the benefit of the community. Thank you for your work, and congratulations on being named one of the 2024 Distinguished Alumni Award recipients.
It's a really nice day. Thank you for being here. Congratulations, class of 2024. We are proud of you. Everybody in this room is proud of you. I can kind of feel the love in the room. I've got two quick pieces of advice. First is, your learning doesn't stop here. Keep learning. Everyone here and everybody out there in the world has something that you can learn from them. Go get it. Number two is, when it's your turn, embrace the opportunity to be an educator. You all have skills, and it's important that you give them back to the next generation. Real quick, thank you to my family for always supporting and loving me. To my son and my daughter, Hunter and Freya, thank you for being my students. And how about a round of applause for the faculty and administrators and everybody that helped you get here.
Thank you, Tom. Next up is Andrew Pierce. Andrew is a 1993 graduate of the college, earning a recreation leadership degree. He continued on for his bachelor's degree at SUNY Cortland and has been a fixture in our communities ever since. He has worked in assisted living facilities, as a recreation therapist at hospitals and rehabilitation centers, and as a recreation director in the town of Dryden and the village of Homer. He is also an entrepreneur, starting with the opening of Drew's Dogs in 2003 and later the Frosty Caboose in Cortland. Whether you think of him as someone who works with the young people in our communities as a coach and a recreation director, or as a successful small business owner, you know that Andrew has always placed great importance on serving the community he loves. Andrew, thank you for all you do, and congratulations on being named a recipient of this year's Distinguished Alumni Award.
Good evening, families, friends, distinguished guests, faculty, administrators, fellow alumni, and soon-to-be fellow graduates of Tompkins-Cortland Community College. To be nominated and selected as a recipient of the 2024 Distinguished Alumni Award for TC3 is a tremendous honor. To see the names of those that nominated me and wrote letters on my behalf was truly humbling. Mayor of Homer, Hal McCabe, Cortland City Clerk, and good friend, Andy Jewett. My former high school basketball coach and former TC3 basketball coach, Mick Lowy, lifetime friends, Christopher Kaiser, Cecile Swift-Lippitt, Lisa Belidoff, Sarah Loris, along with a former player of mine, who is now a standout player at SUNY Cortland, Brooke Tillotson. I want to thank my family and great friends that are here tonight to help me celebrate in this honor. I especially want to thank my mother for all that she has done for me along the way, and my wife, Carrie, whose never-ending love and support has allowed me to follow my dreams and be away from home, coaching games, running camps, clinics, and other community events that I'm involved with. Thank you. To the TC3 Alumni Committee, thank you for this tremendous honor. TC3 graduates, thank you for sharing your night with me. They have said that the world is your oyster and it's up to you to find the pearls. The secret is that the pearls are all around you. They are the people that share your life's journey with you. Don't overlook the pearls. Good fortune to you all. Thank you.
Thank you both. In just a few moments, we will begin the presentation of the diplomas. In addition to their diplomas, after they cross the stage, our newest TC3 alumni will receive two gifts. The first is a fun memento from the TC3 Foundation, something to help you remember your alma mater. The second is a short book called Life's Great Questions by Tom Rath. Tom recently spoke to a group of TC3 faculty and staff that graduated from a leadership development program known as PEAKS. His message is fitting for professionals in any field, but especially so for graduates like you who are about to spend a significant time on your life's journey. I promise this book is an easy read, and there is no quiz when you're done, but I do hope that it helps inspire you to keep asking questions, to keep learning. I trust that your time at TC3 has taught you that learning never stops. We are all lifelong learners. Part of that learning is figuring out our role in making the world a better place. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others?" The class of 2024 has many talents, and I urge each and every one of you to use those talents to do good for yourself and for others. Your achievements are impressive. Let them be just the beginning. And now, the moment we have all been waiting for, we will begin the presentation of diplomas. Provost Reifenheiser, would you please do the honors?
All right. President Kremenek, I am pleased to present to you the class of 2024. Would the candidates please rise? As I present you to the president, please be sure your tassel is on the right side of your mortarboard. President Kremenek, the faculty of Tompkins Cortland Community College has certified the individuals assembled are worthy candidates for the certificates Associate of Applied Science, Associate of Science, and Associate of Arts degree. Therefore, it is my pleasure to present to you the candidates of the class of 2024.
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the State University of New York, Tompkins Cortland Community College Board of Trustees, I hereby confer on each of you the Certificate of Proficiency, the Associate of Applied Science, the Associate of Science, and the Associate of Arts as it is appropriate, with all of the associated rights, privileges, and responsibilities. You may now move your tassels from your right to your left. Chairperson Davison, will you please join me in the presentation of the diplomas to our graduates? Provost Reifenheiser will now begin the presentation of the graduates.
All right, I would ask the graduates to please be seated and follow the directions of the ushers. As our graduates are moving into place, I'm sure you have noticed that several of our graduates are wearing some additional academic regalia. Allow me to offer congratulations to those wearing the gold stoles of the International Honor Society Phi Theta Kappa. These graduates are members of the largest and most distinguished honor society available to our students. And their inclusion in Phi Theta Kappa is a recognition of their academic achievement. You will also notice several graduates wearing green and white cords. These achievement cords recognize student leaders on campus, including officers in student clubs, inductees into the National Society of Leadership and Success, and captains from our athletic teams. Each of these individuals were either nominated or selected by their peers or by college staff as a result of their leadership. In addition, purple cords are worn to signify graduates who have been awarded scholarships or grants supported by private gifts to the college's foundation. And finally, blue cords signify the graduates of our P-TECH Academy, a grant-supported partnership between TST BOCES, TC3, and area businesses to prepare students for high-skills careers in advanced manufacturing, computer technology, and related fields. And now, the class of 2024. Ramnia Quinnell, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Mary Beth Ortlieb, Recreation Leadership, with highest honors, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Christina Vigilati Martinez, Business Administration, with high honor. Louis Scholl, Business Administration, with highest honors. Valencia Gell, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science. Sebastian Bucknor, Graphic Design. Daisy Carroll, Early Childhood Assistant Credential. Caitlin Sill, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Nancy Lynch. Nancy Lynn Sherman, nursing. Kendall Elizabeth Epp, nursing, liberal arts and science general studies, with high honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Amber Smith, nursing. Amanda Smichael, nursing. Andreas Gonsalves, liberal arts and science, adolescence education. Jenna Babbitt, liberal arts and science, general studies. Jacob Parrish, culinary arts. Jasmine Hirschla, business administration. Christina Vargas, accounting with high honors. Corey Hall, liberal arts and science, adolescence education with honor. Tasha Barron, business administration. Michael Hampton, culinary arts, food and beverage service credential. Tatiana Velez, culinary arts with high honors. Milo Coyote, culinary arts with highest honors, food and beverage service credential. Carrie Sabin, business administration. Joanne Kenyon, business administration. Lindsay Martin, liberal arts and science, general studies, with highest honor. Sarah Cargan, liberal arts and science, general studies, with honor. Lana Thousand, business administration. Abigail Foley, criminal justice, human services, with high honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Gabrielle Foley, sport management, with high honor. Mackenzie Fuller, criminal justice. Shantae Fisher Fuller, chemical dependency counseling and the residential aides credential. Jason Rood, communication and media arts. Ariana DeFranco, recreation, exercise studies. Kayla Scuderi, recreation, exercise studies. Cannon Van Duzer, sport management. Cameron Scanlon, accounting. Max Cooley Didinsky, liberal arts and sciences, social science, with highest honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Valentine Jean Jacques, accounting with honor. Andrew Richards, broadcast production radio with honor. Timothy Warren II, broadcast production, television, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Esnilka Gil Perez, Digital Cinema, with honor. Ariella Bustos, Biology, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Cooper Arsenault, Computer Information Systems. Caleb Arsenault, Criminal Justice. Elizabeth Francis McEver, Accounting. David Songer II, Recreation Exercise Studies. Hunter Ryan, Business Administration. Amanda Vestal, Chemical Dependency Counseling, the Chemical Dependency Counselor Assistant Credential, and the Residential Aid Credential. Kayla Ellerson, Graphic Design, with honor. Natasha Michaels, Criminal Justice. Sergey Yureshkin, Computer Information Systems. Stephanie Darling, Hotel and Restaurant Management, with high honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Ulrich Jackson Clare, Liberal Arts and Science General Studies, with highest honors. Angelina Guinevere Masati, Liberal Arts and Science General Studies, with highest honor. Zane Brock Howley, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honors. Thomas Jerome Williams, Liberal Arts and Science General Studies. Emmett Mitterrando, Outdoor Recreation, with highest honor. Jenna Smith, Computer Science, General Sequence.
Pullman?
Yep. Nathan Pullman, Computer Science, General Sequence. Rory Richardson, Computer Science, Engineering, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa, with an entourage. Eva Wolkuski, Computer Science, with highest honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Dustin Gibeon, Engineer in Science, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, and with highest honor. Michael Koch, Engineering Science, with highest honor. Carlos Wallace, Applied Science and Technology, with honor, and a PTech graduate. Dana Elston, Engineering Science, with high honor. Carion Johnson, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies.
Yeah. Your Z's are good, thank you.
Matthew Thomas, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Ryan Root, Criminal Justice, with high honor. Liam Terry, Business Administration with honor. Blake Terry, Business Administration with high honor.
Zapata.
Austin Zapata, Chemical Dependency Counseling and the Residential Aid Credential.
Matthew Fellows.
Matthew Fellows, Human Services with highest honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa.
Sharkey.
Theodore Sharkey, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with high honor. Samuel Scott, Applied Science and Technology, with highest honor. Colin Dungy, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, Liberal Arts and Science General Studies, with high honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Rupert Robbins, Chemical Dependency Counseling, with high honor. Justina Aponte, Liberal Arts and Science, Social Science. Sarah Gardell, Hotel and Restaurant Management, with honor. Tammy Argetsinger, Computer Support Specialist. Cassidy Blake, Liberal Arts and Science, Early Childhood Education, and the Early Childhood Assistant Credential. Age Mucher, Early Childhood and the Early Childhood Assistant Credential. Caitlin Aysen, Sustainable Farming and Food Systems. Meg Gelder, Chemical Dependency Counseling with highest honor, and the Chemical Dependency Counselor Assistant Credential and the Residential Aid Credential. Rashana Durham Armstrong, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Jennifer Amberg, Liberal Arts and Science, Social Science, with highest honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Jackson Robinson, Biology. Wendy Shirley Lisa Guabanunatu Sumani, Biology, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa from Gabon.
That was a hard one.
Jessica Strange, Liberal Arts and Science, Adolescence Education, with highest honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. LJ Baez, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Anna Brown, Liberal Arts and Science, Adolescence Education. Jeremiah Sokol, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Junior Yasiro Pacheco Gil, International Business, with honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Okay. Ambar Edith Venveris, International Business with high honor. Amy Liz Guzman Pina, International Business with highest honor. Laura Maria Fernandez Bejaran, Construction and Environmental Technology with highest honor, and with the Geotechnical Lab Technician credential and the Surveying Technician credential. Sharon Abigail Benavidez Contreras, Business Administration, Entrepreneurship with honor. Kieran Giselle Cedinho Enirio, International Business. Jorge Alejandro Zuniga Figueroa, Computer Information Systems with honor. I probably missed that one. Lene Lodman, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Orlando Walthall, Liberal Arts and Science, Social Science. Michael Cavanaugh, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Vincent Beyer, Nursing, with high honor. Molly Walczewski, Nursing, with honor. Spencer Horry, Human Services, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Mason Zoner, Computer Information Systems, Computer Support Specialist, with honor, and a PTech graduate. Gavin Metcalf, Computer Support Specialist with high honor. Ryan June, New Media with highest honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Holly Freilich, New Media with high honor. Jenna Lavancha, Photography. Elizabeth Cobb, New Media, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Sydney Lilly, Accounting, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Sam McAvoy, Graphic Design, with honor. Rhiannon Galloway, Photography, with honor. Valentine Murray, Applied Science and Technology, and a PTech graduate. Lori Fulton Lostro, Graphic Design with highest honor.
That's a great name.
Thank you.
Orion Ezekiel Maynard Shaw Willett, Graphic Design with highest honor.
Micah, Jonathan Micah. I asked about your name ahead of time to make sure I didn't screw it up.
Jonathan Micah, Graphic Design. Emma Mayen, Liberal Arts and Science, Humanities, with highest honor. Chao La, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Brianna Lynn Bartow, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Isabel Lorraine Johnson, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Sophie Elizabeth Riedel, Biology, with highest honor. Elsie Donlick, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Cadence Bischoff Habicht, Business Administration, with honor.
Thank you.
Amariana Dixon, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. All right. Regina Fischetti, paralegal, with honor, and the Special Education Advocacy Credential. David Januska, criminal justice. Matthew Zawiski, computer information systems, computer support specialist, with honor. Alyssa Rinchak, Construction and Environmental Technology and the Geotechnical Lab Technician Credential. Nakia Eddy, Culinary Arts with high honor. Jonathan Elmore, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Devin Fairchild, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Brooklyn McNaught, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Riley Ray Faith Noon, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Mia Caitlin Cummings, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Anna Cable, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Alexandria Rose Brett, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Grace Elizabeth Handy, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Aubrey Laura Kastenhuber, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Eli Andrew Cornwell, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Jacqueline Marie Brown, Liberal Arts and Sciences, General Studies, with high honor. Lydia Margaret Kuster, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Erica Ann Olson, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Amanda Grover, Business Administration. Kurt Louie, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Eli Gordon, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Karima McCray, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Jamie Taylor, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Laura Tanqueri, Liberal Arts and Science, Social Science, with high honor. Ethan Swanhart, New Media. Violet Marube, Nursing, with honor.
Sladen.
Asher Sladen, Creative Writing, Screenwriting, with high honor.
Ross.
David Bloss, Culinary Arts, with honor, and the Food and Beverage Service credential. Ethan Gibbs, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Maud Royce Terwilliger, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Sarah Lynn Williams, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Campbell Carpenter Bush, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with high honor. Reese Lynn Whitney, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Brianna May Bergen, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor.
Leah Sarah Grace.
Yeah.
That's all you want? Leah Sarah Grace? Okay. Oh, Young.
Leah Sarah Grace Youngins, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor.
Starinsky?
Ella K. Starinsky, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Christina Grace Stanton, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor.
Riley
Mitchell Madden, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Lauren Elizabeth Mott, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with high honor. Madeline Marie Perkins, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor.
Reagan Marie Allen.
Reagan Marie Allen, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Taryn J. Latre, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Nicholas Richard Gammel, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Carter Scott Nagany, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Carter's degree will be presented by Carter's aunt, Sandy Moser, a TC3 faculty member. Rashida H. Shigar, nursing, with honor. Fatima Asara Katani, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Penny Zacharias, nursing, with high honor, and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Tatiana Ross, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Crystal Smith Scarlett, Criminal Justice. Aniqua Wilkerson, Liberal Arts and Sciences, General Studies.
Antonio Montalvo.
Caramia Antonia Montalvo, Liberal Arts and Science General Studies with high honors. Claire Eliza Turner, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honors. Valerosa Patricia Nike Gambetta, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honor. Ethan Alexander Kelsey, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with high honor. Darius Lambright, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honor. Spencer Richard Dodds, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honor. Jack David Phelan, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honor. Fyodor Viktorovich Kalituk, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with highest honor. Genevieve Virginia Femino, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science with high honor. Mackenzie May Lyman, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies with honor. Tyler Joshua Rowe, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Bryn Elizabeth Blaze, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Leah Corinne Peralt, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Michaela Kennedy, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Dykeman. Elizabeth Grace Dykeman, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies.
Delaney Jean Ayer.
Delaney Jane Ayer, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Abigail Grace Sill, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Sharla Elizabeth Lockwood, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Jaden Elizabeth Craig, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Drew Garrison Bush, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Yolanda Cannon, Nursing.
Caitlin R. Lee Bowdery.
Bowdery, thank you. Caitlin R. Lee Bowdery, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with high honor. Brandon Rafferty, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Deacon Cale Bailey, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Abigail Marie Johnson, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Jocelyn Marie Masiak, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Elise Haney, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Alexis Ann Ward, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Chloe Elizabeth Gillette, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Hannah Marie Mahalik, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Samantha Rose Shirley, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Lainey Ashlyn Whitmore, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Caitlin Ann Vasey Hunt, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Nicholas McCabe, Business Administration. Owen David Bronk, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Zachariah James Julian Hammond, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Sipe? Yes. Jacob Sipe, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor.
Pollock?
Pavlock?
Daniel Christopher Pavlock, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. James Thomas Berry, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Devin Douglas Portsline, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. John Joseph Sanford, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Aiden Sky Avery, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Jaden Sophia Wolf, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Julia Antonio Garcia, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Sadie Olivia Parker, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Jasmine Jackson, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. Zoe Ann Slater, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science. Haley Rose Stevens, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Catherine Rose Donnelly Taylor, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Kira Shea Lane, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with highest honor. Olivia Jeanette Bundy, Liberal Arts and Science, Math Science, with honor. Liberty Marie Hollywood, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Abigail Hope Blauvelt, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with high honor. Paige Ann Robinson, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with highest honor. Nehemiah James Anthony, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies, with honor. Valentina Manu, Liberal Arts and Science, General Studies. And And can we get one last round of applause for all of our graduates, please?
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I extend our sincere congratulations to all of the graduates and your families and friends who are gathered here, and our profound appreciation to our special guests that joined us here tonight. Thank you also to the faculty and staff who have worked to make this celebration a special and unique occasion. As we conclude this evening's commencement ceremonies, I would like to invite our graduates, families, and friends to a celebratory reception to be held immediately following the ceremony in the Borg Warner Morse Tech Fieldhouse, located just outside the doors of the gymnasium to your left. Ushers will help direct everyone. I will ask all of our guests in the audience to please wait in your seats until the platform party and all of the graduates have exited the gym. Graduates will continue directly to the fieldhouse following the ceremonies, and they will meet you there. As we close, allow me one final thought. Graduates, I am honored to be in your presence this evening and to recognize and uphold your achievements. As you prepare to head into the next chapter of your life, I have one more simple request for each of you, the members of the graduating class of 2024. Do good. Be patient, be kind, use what you have learned, and take every chance you get to help others. A world of possibilities is in front of you, and the world is yours. Make the most of it. Congratulations again to all of you on behalf of Tompkins-Cortland Community College, the TC3 Class of 2024.
A celebration to last throughout the years.